Miami-Dade County is home to the largest percentage of people with serious mental illness of any urban community in the United States. So what makes Miami-Dade so unique? Laura?
Miami-Dade is so unique just because we're a transient community. We got a lot of people that travel here. We also have warm climate. So we're a big urban area. So it makes it very easy for people to come to our community, stay here because it's easy to stay here, and then experience these mental health or substance abuse crises.
And here's another startling note that I found as well. According to the 11th Judicial Circuit Court of Florida, fewer than 30% of these individuals receive care in the public mental health system. Wow. So how does this impact our community, Doctor?
Well, you know, I think we should frame some context here. Nationally, the numbers are also high.
Okay.
So, you know, it's estimated that 20% of the U.S. population will have a mental health condition at some point in their life. Mm-hmm. If we dial this down to the serious mental health conditions, schizophrenia, major depression, bipolar disorder, now we're talking probably a little bit above 10%. But then when you add in major substance abuse problems, that's another 10%. Mm. So any way you shake it, you're looking at one in five people. Now, when we talk about, let's talk about the 10% with major mental health conditions like schizophrenia and bipolar disorder, when you now say, okay, not the whole population, but the indigent population, those people who don't have financial resources, now that's almost 17%.
Wow.
So here in Miami, you know, we've got a large indigent population. We've got people who are below the federal poverty line. And that population, wherever we were in the country, was going to be at high risk for these major mental health conditions. And the problem is that we have limited resources. It's not just limited funds, but the number of available beds.
Exactly.
And so, you know, we're doing our best to try to cover this. After they get our gap safety net services, the idea is that those who are eligible could then transition onto Medicaid.